Hi, good evening, Corey Thorne, psychic medium, spiritual healer, and life coach. I am coming in to do a channeled message for the month of May, starting with my Aquarius. And please remember that these messages are to be taken as entertainment only and not to replace any medical, scientific, or psychological advice that you have been given. And also, this message is a general message. This is not a personal reading. If you would like to book a personal reading with me, you can book video sessions on my website, coreythorne.com. All the information will be posted below. And you can also go to my Facebook page and private message me there as well. So this is for a channel message. I am not an astrologer. I do use bits and pieces of astrology, but I am not in any way an astrologer. I work with oracle cards, and the cards that I use are those of other people's. They are not my own at this moment. And so the messages that I am passing are coming from the channel and not from the intention of the people that created these cards. I use them as a validation. So the month of May for my Aquarius. And the Aquarius came up to me with a sense of eyes, being able to see, kind of see clearly that the push and drive that you have been doing, if some of you have been having that pushing yourself and driving yourself through, like, just, I got to keep going, I got to keep doing this. Or if you are really linking, or if you've been pushing somebody else, if you've been pushing other people, come on, we got to keep going, we got to keep doing this, we got to keep going in this direction, making things happen, then this is kind of, May is the month that you're going to see it coming to life. And I don't know, I see wings. I see like just flying, you know, like you've got your own set of wings, just like about to fly. Time, you're about to take off. You're about to go a whole new direction. And it's like deep soul searching. May is a time of deep soul searching for a lot of my Aquarius. It's like, okay, you've been sitting still for a while, sitting in your pain, sitting in your grieving, whatever it may have been. And it's heart wrench. Like, I feel like there's been a lot of heart wrench for some of my Aquarius. Like, I have to experience this. I need to sit in this. And you've had your time and you're feeling like you've probably missed out on some other stuff, saying, I just feel like I've been so bombarded, so overwhelmed with so many things. And it's like, now I need to go deep into myself, deep inward, and do the soul searching that needs to take place. It's a sense of feeling as if there's a collective. So it feels like there's a lot of people that have been feeling this way. A lot of people that have been kind of shining a light upon you, saying, remember what you've done for everybody else. Remember how valuable you are. Remember how kind you are. Remember. And that's what the soul searching is coming in, is that you're being reminded, you're remembering who you were, but you're remembering who you were on a whole different level. You're not just remembering who you are in this life, remembering who you were in other times. You're remembering who you were before you ever showed up as a human. You're remembering what it was like to kind of make those contracts before we got here. You're remembering that, you know what, maybe I signed up for some of this. Maybe this is what I signed up for in my life. And now I kind of have to stand up and shine. I need to stand up and be of service. I need to stand up and help, or I need to really truly find what my soul is, what my soul purpose is, what I want to do with my life. I want to be that kind of the magician of your own life. You want to be magical. You want to live a somewhat of a magical life. You want to be able to be there for other people and to be able to kind of snap your fingers and make things go away for others, because you know what it's like to live in pain, hurt, and grief. And what it's coming up for me is that you're going to be there to be able to help other people through. So whoever you are, whatever group of you that's going through this or feeling like that's your change, then this is kind of the month that it's kind of showing up for you. Like, you're really starting to explore or starting to see a lot of the signs that are happening around you. It's like, this is a one way. Remember that this is one way. You're only going one way. You only have one way out of here. What are you going to do with the rest of the years? What are you going to do with the rest of the time that you have? You have so much to give. You have so much life to live. You have so much to show, teach, and so much compassion and kindness in your heart. Don't stop doing what you're doing. Don't stop the forward growth. Be okay with the fact that some of you have had to go through these times and others have been kind of bouncing through life like everything is totally fine. I'm totally happy. Everything is all good. Good, good, good if that was you. But some people have not. It's been like the past few months or the past year was a real struggle. I'm picking up some grandma energy here. I'm picking up that whether you're the old soul or you are the grandma or you're about to become a grandma or you're about to make somebody else a grandma. But the grandmother energy is the grandmother energy is what I'm picking up. And the grandmother energy is the wisdom, the wise soul. Listen to the ones of wisdom. If you are the voice of wisdom, don't feel the need to think that you need to pass on your all-knowing energy to everybody else. This is not your time to pass on your all-knowing energy by forcing upon people. People will come to you as needed. Or if you're the one needing that advice for somebody else, don't be afraid to go towards them because they're not going to be pushing it upon you. Don't be afraid to ask for help. Don't be afraid to ask for help. Don't be afraid to step up. Don't be afraid to stand in your light. And this is also, May is also a time for my Aquarius that family, 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 family. I'm picking up a lot of family, family, family. Letting go of old resentments, old hate. I'm going to say hate. I know it's a very strong word, but I feel like for some of my Aquariuses, there's been some hate. Like, I hate that family member. I hate that person. Or I hate what they did to us. Da, 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 da. And a lot of it was stuff that you've heard. Things that you've heard from other family members. Or it's things that are so old that you don't even know what the real story really is anymore. Remember that. Sometimes we need to be grateful for the people that we have. And I feel like sometimes Aquarius, you're not being grateful. You're not saying thank you. Not all of you. Some. Say thank you to the relationship. Say thank you to your partners. Even if it's a relationship that's ending, say your thank you. Thank you for the, you know, you might not want to say it to them, but it is say thank you to those who've been there for you. Thank you for the opportunity to experience what I experienced. And some's like, thank you that you're gone. Thank you that you're not in my life no more. Thank you that you made a choice to leave me, or thank you that you made a choice to make sure you weren't in my life no more, whatever it may be. But it's like, just be grateful that some things have left your life that needed to leave, but also be very thankful that new things are coming in. There's a whole sense of becoming for my Aquarius. It's all around you. You're becoming your true self. You're becoming the essence of who you are supposed to be. Your deep dive into your soul search is leading you all in the right direction. The leaving of relationships, the moving in of new relationships, it's all the sense of becoming a whole, becoming a whole family, coming together. Everything just feels like coming full circle for my Aquarius. Do not continue to sit in the energy you have been sitting in, because if you do, it's sitting yourself in like a victim role. It is time to move forward and move into survivor, warrior, whatever it may be, but allow yourself to move into that new sense of becoming, because you are becoming so much more than what you were a month ago, 2 months ago, a year ago. May brings beautiful flowers. You are one of those beautiful flowers that are blossoming and growing and opening in so many ways. Embrace, enjoy, and I hope this serves you well. Much love to you all. Bye-bye.